Last week I got a few of these cheap Chinese USB sound cards. They are about £1 each. And when I plugged this in, I heard that the headphones made quite loud popping sound, and the sound quality was awful. So I thought this was rubbish, but I didn't throw them away. What I did was that I opened them. It's quite easy, just take the flat-headed screwdriver and try to find some kind of hole where you can push it and take the case apart. Quite simple circuit. There's the epoxy blob that has the integrated circuit inside it and few passive components outside it. And what I noticed was that here, right next to the input and output jacks, there are those small holes and pads for capacitors. There are C20 and C23, and they are not populated. Instead, there are traces going between those pads, shorting them. And that made me think that maybe there should be capacitors in them, in those places. So I took my multimeter and measured the voltage between the ground and left and right pins on the output jack, and what I found was that there was over 2 volts DC offset on those pins, and that's not good for the headphones. So I got the traces that shorted those pads that I showed earlier, and I added capacitors on those places where they should be. The ones I used are 220 microfarads, and they are quite good for 32 ohm headphones. And after I placed those capacitors in place, the sound quality became quite good for the price, of course, and there was no offset voltage in the output pins. That way I made this £1 USB sound card much better.